Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Unity on a Sunday morning. Here we go.
Think of the fellow man, lend him a helping hand, put a little love in your heart. You see it's getting late. Oh, please don't hesitate. Put a little love in your heart,
and the world
will be a better place,
and the world
will be a better place for you. Just wait and see.
Oh,
another day goes by, and still the children cry. Put a little love in your heart. We want the world to know. We won't let hatred grow. Put a little love in your heart,
and the world
will be a better place,
and the world.
Just wait and see.
Oh, take a good look around, and if you're looking down,
put a little love in your heart.
I hope when you decide, kindness will be your guide.
Put a little love in your heart.
Stand up and sing this song with us. That would be great. It's called One Great Power. As soon as the PowerPoint comes up, we can all do that together. I think the great thing about putting a little love in your heart, if we all put a little love in our heart, it ends up being a great big love. All right, here we go.
There was one great presence just on fire, shining in the world like a beacon in the night. There's just one power we all can share, one great power everywhere.
Whoa.
One great power, one great love, big as the ocean and the skies above. One great spirit waiting in prayer, one great power everywhere. One great power everywhere. Just one purpose, just one spark, burning in our souls like a candle in the dark. There's just one chorus we all can sing, one great power, let it ring. One great power, one great love, big as the ocean and the skies above. One great spirit waiting in prayer, one great power everywhere. One great love, big as the ocean and the skies above. One great spirit waiting in prayer, one great power everywhere. One great power everywhere. One great power everywhere.
Yeah. right. You can still stand or sit, whatever you care to do. Your choice. We all know there's enough love right here inside this room to heal the world. There's enough love. Go. Nice singing, everybody.
Good morning, everyone. Is that love flowing through your hearts right now? Good. Keep it flowing. Let's take a moment for an affirmative prayer. Everyone relax. Feel your feet planted on the floor. And feel the love of Mother Earth pouring up through your feet, supporting you, holding you up. And then imagine the light of the stars. Even though it's daylight, they're still up there pouring their light down onto Mother Earth, down onto you. So imagine those lights pouring down through the top of your head and the love of Mother Earth coming up from the ground and meeting in your heart. That light, that presence is all around you all the time. Feel it now. Feel the universe supporting you. Notice your breath as you breathe in. That is the breath of life. It's what keeps you alive and animated. And it's there for you whenever you need it. With every breath, it's there for you. Give thanks for that breath, for that is the universe supporting you. And we are all breathing the same air, which means we are all connected to this source of love and light and life. Accept it. Trust it. Have faith that whatever you need will be provided for you. just take a moment to feel the love in your own heart and offer it up to the world. So many people in the world right now are afraid, worried, anxious, wondering what's going to happen. Allow the peace within your own heart to reach out to them. They will feel it. Prayer is a powerful way to connect you to the world, and it makes a difference. And knowing this, I declare it so, and so it is. My name is Bob Elwood. I'm part of the spiritual leadership team here at Unity of Calgary. And I'd like to say hello to all of you here and all of you out there watching on Facebook or YouTube. I hope you could feel that connection that we all have. And not just in this community. There are communities all over the world right now gathering. And we are connected to all of them. Here at Unity, we have what we call our statement of being, the reason we come here every Sunday. So please, affirm out loud with me our statement of being. We are here as love to celebrate the one power, the one presence in our lives, in this community, and in the universe. And as usual, we have our daily word reader, someone from the community that comes up each week to read our daily word. And for those of you who would like to read our daily word, there is a sign-up sheet on the bulletin board out in the hallway. So please, fill your name in. We've already got all of March booked. Woohoo! I love it. So please sign up if you feel called to be one of our daily word readers. And today we have our very own Stefan Belgrave, our amazing secretary on the board that does an exceptional job. And we're so grateful to have him as part of our board. Let's please welcome Stefan Belgrave.
Thank you very much, Bob. A very meow introduction. Okay, so today's daily word is glory. My life celebrates the glory of God. Glory fills the world with wonder when I attune my senses to it. I hear it in the sound of waves crashing on a beach and in the resonant harmony of a choir. I see it in sunrises and sunsets, in the beauty of gardens, mountains, and forests, and in the eyes of parents holding their newborn child. I feel glory in the depths of my being at those moments when I understand my life as God's life, living as me. There is no place where my human self ends and the divine presence in me begins. God and I are one. The glory of God is revealed in me as I release the thought that I am only human. God's glory shines through me as the divine presence, the Christ, expressing in my healthy body, my insightful mind, and my loving heart. And from Galatians 2:20, it is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me. I have something to say. I work for probably one of the most difficult companies on the planet. Most people would hail it as the hero of the planet, but everyone's perspective is different. And I completely lost my cool with someone, and then I realized I am here to love. I'm not here to correct someone or tell them how to do their job or anything like that. I'm there to love. And so later that evening, we had some downtime, and I just sat there and prayed. I just reconnected. I reminded myself that I am love. Thank you.
Thank you, Stefan. A good reminder for all of us. We are all love. Unity Worldwide has a vision, and we've taken that vision on here at Unity of Calgary. And if it speaks to you, please affirm out loud with me our vision. We envision a world powerfully transformed through the growing movement of shared spiritual awakening. And how we do that here at Unity of Calgary is through our mission statement. So please affirm that out loud with me. We are a welcoming, vibrant, spiritual community that inspires hearts and transforms lives by expressing our divine essence. And what does that mean? It means that every week you come here and express yourself. And that is how we create community, by sharing ourselves with each other. And by, as Stephen said, seeing through love, seeing the other in a loving, kind way, regardless of circumstances. And of course, that can be a challenge sometimes. But you are all spiritual beings, and you can all do it. Now, some upcoming events. In our community news, next week's speaker, Lewis David Levin. I reached out to him a month and a half ago to see if he would be one of our speakers. And I didn't really know him that well, but one of our members, Brenda Hall, had mentioned his name. And so we thought, well, let's just reach out and see. And I spoke to him, and I really liked his energy, and I went online to find out more about him. He's a musician. He does kirtan. And anybody that was here for the movie Mantra last month, or the month of January's movie, that's how we got to hear about him, because Brenda says, oh, well, there's this Lewis David Levin that does kirtan here in Calgary, I thought, which is kind of like a chanting music. And he travels the world. He's a musician. He's also the founder of the fellowship for, I forget exactly the name, but Paramahansa Yogananda created fellowships all over the world, and he opened the Calgary chapter and ran it for like 20 years. And so I'm really looking forward to hearing what he has to say. He's going to be speaking, and he's also going to do an extended meditation with some chanting. He's got a vibranium, I think it's called, which is like a piano accordion kind of a thing, that he's going to be playing some music for us. He's going to be our special musical guest next week. So I'm really looking forward to it. And I hope you all come out to enjoy what he has to say about health and spirit. And after the experience on next Sunday is our monthly potluck. So please come on out. Bring a friend if you like, bring some good food, or you can just bring your own food if that serves you better. It's up to you. Then on March 20th, we have our book study. We were going to stop this book study on the Law of Divine Compensation by Marianne Williamson last month, but we had a good turnout and everybody was very engaged, and they said, no, let's not stop, let's keep going. So that's what we're going to do. So on March 20th, after the experience, or Sunday experience, we're going to have the book study with the Law of Divine Compensation based on chapters 7, 8, and 9. Then on March 26th, which is a Saturday, we have our Peace March. It's going to start at 2 o'clock, and we're going to all meet at the north end of the Peace Bridge. Our very own Tina Thrussell has been organizing this event for years, and I believe she'll be one of the organizers this year as well. I was there for the last several years, and it's a wonderful march of love and peace. So come on out and join us. Then on March 27th, we have our Unity Spiritual Cinema, our movie matinee. And we got the movie, The Wisdom of Trauma, with Gabor Mate. I highly recommend this film. I hope you all come out, tell your friends. This is a powerful movie, and I think it could be a wonderful healing opportunity for many of us. And we're going to have a sharing at the end. We'll all sit in a big circle and share our experience of the movie and perhaps our experience of our own traumas in our own life. So please, come on out. Really share it with everybody you know. Let's get a good crowd out there on March 27th. There's also a reminder that every Sunday we have these beautiful, usually have these beautiful snacks over for the by the coffee. That, and our two main people that cook these beautiful snacks are Ariana Brackenberry and Ross, our tech guy, who's actually in Victoria right now. And neither of them are here at the moment. So we're missing those delicious snacks. So if you feel called to bake up a few cookies, or a little bit of meat or date loaf or whatever you like, please. Please feel free to bring it on Sunday mornings. Also, a big reminder that next weekend is daylight savings time. And it's spring, so we spring ahead. We move our clocks ahead 1 hour. So don't forget. And now Anthony, he wasn't feeling too well this week, so he took the caution of staying home. And so we have our very own assistant music director, Vivianne Martin, to play some of her beautiful music. Let's please welcome Vivianne.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, Anthony, he sent me a message on Friday saying, you know, not feeling 100%, would you want to do the music on Sunday? I was like, absolutely, sure. So he said, I'm grateful, very grateful that he did say, he said, I didn't want to wait till Saturday to, you know, have you organize it all. So thank you, Anthony, and we send our love and healing light to you. This song was actually written in the 1950s by a songwriter. His name is Ed McCurdy. And he wrote it in 1950. And in 1956, Pete Seeger recorded it. And he recorded it, and the album was called, he called it Strangest Dream. And this hit me. The album name was Love Songs for Friends and Foes. And at this point in time on the planet, how important is that it's like for myself, I have opportunities around that. And so stepping into this song this morning, it's called Last Night I Had the Strangest Dream. Last night I had the strangest dream that I ever dreamed. I dream the world had all agreed to put an end to war. I dreamed I saw a mighty room filled with women. And the paper they were signing said they'd never fight again. And when the paper all was signed and a million copies made, they all joined hands and bowed their heads and grateful prayers were prayed. And the the people in the streets below were dancing round and round, and the swords and guns and uniforms were scattered all around. And when the paper all was sight and
What a perfect song for this morning, is it not? What a great dream, too. We can dream that. Let's dream an end to war. What a wonderful dream. And it is doable. I totally believe it is doable. In that peace that we're creating in that dream, we create the space for our speaker today, Reverend Doug Craig. He's been on this spiritual path for 43 years. Holy cow. And he's going to speak today about I am whole, perfect, and complete in all ways. He always brings a wonderful perspective and also his own personal experience to the table when he speaks. So let us all please welcome our own Reverend Doug Craig as our speaker today.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. How's everybody this morning? Just before I begin, Bob was talking earlier about Paramahansa Yogananda and his work. That's the Self-Realization Fellowship. I followed Paramahansa Yogananda for many, many years and saw some of his disciples speak live. Excellent teacher. Excellent philosophy he does. So I'm going to begin with a meditation today, and I'm going to call upon Vivian in a moment. The meditation is going to cover and work with this month's theme, which is health. And also part of health, in order to have health of any kind, we need to have peace. We have to have peace within ourselves before we can have health. And our world needs a lot of peace today. And I really thank you for that song, Vivian. So when I start the meditation, after Vivian takes us in, if you do color, I'm going to start with peace and go into health. But if you do color and it works for you, I invite you to see blue and yellow in your meditation, okay?
Here and now.
So we begin by knowing and accepting that there is one eternal life that is forever giving of itself, and that's God's life, my life, your life, right here and right now. So as I speak this word for myself, I invite all of you to participate in this word and accept it as yours. I hold and support this world of ours in a vision of love, life, and light, knowing that the essence of peace, which is the essence and the core of our very being, emanates from within us to encircle our globe, bringing peace and love to all whom are there to receive it, knowing there is no judgment, no sides, only this one eternal life. And we need to work together to visualize and experience this peace. And from that, we embrace health. And let us know together that I am whole, perfect, and complete in all ways and at all times. I know and accept that the divine healing presence of good and God is in me, flows through me, and expresses by means of me in my own unique and special way. I now experience perfect circulation, assimilation, and elimination in all of my bodily functions, in all of my physical, mental, and emotional affairs. And I know that divine right action takes place in my life, and there is a gradual, orderly, sequential unfoldment into form of the highest and best that I can be. So let's take this vision of peace and health into the quietness of meditation and experience it and contemplate it in our own unique and special way. So as we come back into conscious awareness, we do so knowing that how we conduct and visualize ourself not only affects the world of our health, but it impacts the world in general. We may say, what difference can I make? The power of God and the power of consciousness from the individual is the most powerful thing that we have. And collectively, individually, if we unite in this, consciousness will prevail above all of what's going on around us, in us, and through us. So we accept that we deserve to experience the very best. It is ours now, and we accept it.
Here and now, I am peace. Here and now, I am love. Here and now, I am joy. Here and now.
Thank you, Vivian. I want to thank you for the song that you played and for leading us into meditation. That was wonderful. So what we're focusing in on today is health. It's the beginning of the health month. And the affirmation Unity provides is, we are the expression of health that God is. I am the expression of health that God is. Okay? Now, there's a lot of different ways you could look at this, but I'm going to give you a little idea. This is just all my own personal perception on the journey. And as Bob says, it's 43 years, so in 2 weeks, if you subtract my birthday from that, that made me 30 when I come into this philosophy. Okay? So it's been quite a journey, and it was hell on wheels before that, folks. It was just one of the most unreal experiences that you ever want to go through, and I don't advise it. But it did give me the basis for a lot of what I do today. So these are my own perceptions and the way I see it. So there's two ways that we're going to look at health. We're going to look at it as, I already got a problem. What am I going to do? Then we're going to look at it as, I don't like those problems. What can I do? Okay? There's only two ways to look at this health. So the first way is looking at the physical conditions we may be experiencing, no matter what they are. Okay? And I am a big proponent, as what Ernest Holmes said in The Teaching of the Science of Mind, one of his books is, open at the top. Ernest Holmes always said, no matter what you know, no matter what is known, that's not all. There's more. So keep it open at the top. Don't ever think that you know it all or get smug. Anybody done that? Because in this philosophy with us, if you do that, you get your butt kicked, seriously. Okay, so there are two ways to deal with what's going on now. Medical and metaphysical. Medical deals with the conditions and the curative. Metaphysical deals with the trends, the preventive, and the first cause. So let me talk a little bit more about that. I've always been a proponent, and ever since I turned a corner 40 some odd years ago, I have really not had a whole lot of medical attention or care, except when I was dying a couple of times. Okay? So, you know, I am like Ernest Holmes. He believed you did whatever you needed to do to experience your healing. So when I was in Italy with Anna and had that experience, and we made it back, and I had major surgery 25 days, and they still couldn't figure out how I got it back from Italy alive. They just still don't know that, but they don't understand, do they? Okay? It's a power of spiritual and mental resolve that carries us through that. So I needed medical attention. If I had not had that surgery to get things straightened around, we would not be having this conversation today. So it served its purpose for me. Okay? I did not participate in all of the medical procedure, because after they took me off my thing for surgery, I refused drugs. I didn't take any drugs. I haven't done, since I got my turnaround made, it took a few years after I started, by the way, I haven't done any drugs, prescription or illegal. I do use some pain stuff, but it's legal now. Should have been legal. Well, that's another story, another talk. But anyhow, in all that time, you know, and I've been challenged by them. Oh, you got to do it because your pain will spike. I got to say, honey, this ain't nothing. Try coming on a gurney after you hit a car at 60K on a Harley when you wake up. It takes a different level of pain, eh? Different level. So it's all relative. So anyhow, I needed it, I took it, and that's it. Metaphysically, I knew my body was in disrepair at that time, so I had a, what did I use? Who's the first person I called? Practitioner. to come and see me. And one, I couldn't get a hold, left a message. I called another one, and they both come within a few hours. Hated this session at all. I hated it. They made me so upset because they told me, Doug, you got control issues, and now you got to let go of control and work with it. I didn't like that. Both, I thought, you guys talk to each other? But you call your practitioner and get that spiritual component, because you need the spiritual self working in here to experience the physical healing. You got to have the two going together. So how do I work the system here? We're going to go into the preventative part here. So how do I work that a little bit? Well, I go and I get an annual medical, usually 2 years for me, but no, it's get medical insurance and stuff. And what I do is I first call my naturopath, okay? I have a naturopath that I've been seeing many, many years. She's just great. And my medical doctor. So I say, what kind of blood tests do you need, dear? She sends them to me. I tell the doctor I need these tests as well as what you're going to do. He gets the tests done. I get a copy, send it to my naturopath. Why do I do that? No fee. If the naturopath orders it, you have to pay a fee just to save some money for you, okay? So here's what happened in the recent one, just to give you an example of what I'm talking about. The doctors will look at the blood tests, and they got certain flags. If it isn't at that level, oh, you're okay. My naturopath doesn't do that. She takes the last three or four times I've done it over the last 8 years, and she looks at trends. So she said, Doug, I don't like the trend where your thyroid's going. It's going up this way slowly. Now, she said, the doctor won't tell you about it because it's not near the critical point. But this is where it's going, and I don't like it. So I'm getting some more tests, and we're going to work on preventative. You got that? Don't wait till the engine starts smoking. Get it serviced. Hello? Anybody with that? Yeah. Don't wait till your body gets that way. Get it serviced. Right? We got to do that if we want to do it. Preventative. And it works exceptionally well for me so far. But that's just to give you one little example of preventative versus wait until there's a problem and then trying to fix it. Okay? And to me, that's where sometimes the medical falls down. Why I go to the naturopath, because she identifies that and I can work with it before it gets there. Now it might get there, but at least I could put it off for a while, and I'm into putting stuff off till later. I'm 73 in 2 weeks. I want to put it off till 93 if I can choke it that far. Right? And that's a whole lot better than odds, because nobody said Doug would live past 33. Not my four younger siblings that are all dead, or my brother that's in a care facility. Nobody thought. All the people, nobody thought. And there, to me, is only one reason. That's because I got into this teaching and began to take care of business. Oh, I'm a slow learner, folks. I haven't got it all yet. You know, maybe in another 10, 15 years, I might get a handle on it. But it's something that you got to work with. So now we're talking about the healing aspect. And this is where Centers for Spiritual Living and Unity really come together, because it's all about spiritual mind healing. It's all about healing. And basically, there's a little bit different ways that we pray, but it's just technique. The bottom line for both ways that we look at it is affirmative prayer. Don't say, I am not stupid. I am intelligent and I act intelligently, you know. You got to be careful with affirmative prayer. I remember going up, I'm going to Hawaii and I need money. Never went to Hawaii till I got rid of that, I need money. Because you don't need money to go to Hawaii. Somebody might take you. You might win a trip, or like me, I got paid to go there twice. I've only been there twice, but I got paid. Don't put limitations and restrictions on it. Either one works. Dr. Maxine Kay, who is the senior minister, been in this since she was 12 years old, and she's 80 plus right now, great lady. She says, court the presence and direct the law. Because the law works through you by means of you, no matter what you want to say, no matter what you do. If you put seeds in the ground, it'll grow. So that's the law. So we direct the law to grow what we want. But to do that, we court the presence. And courting the presence is when we get into that space to do our affirmative prayer, our spiritual mind treatment, or whatever it is that we do. That's courting the presence. And then we direct the law from there. Now, the other part that, in my opinion, is the most important part of everything and anything that we could do with health is the metaphysical preventative method. And the preventative method is really what the great teacher said. It's how you maintain your inner house. And that on a day-to-day basis definitely over a period of time affects your health. Anybody had a bad toothache? It didn't start that way, but it starts gently. And then it becomes more and more annoying. And then it's, well, we should get this looked at. I can't deal with it. And then it's panic and emergency surgery. Well, not everybody does it like Doug does, but, you know, we do it that way. So we want to work at preventative. One of my most favorite, my second most favorite book I've ever read, I just love it. And the most powerful quote I've ever come across, I think, in my journey is by Eric Butterworth in Spiritual Economics. Science of Mind is number one for me by Ernest Holmes. If you carefully search within yourself, you may come to the awareness that your most important asset is the conscious control of your own life. Nothing else can satisfy or fulfill unless you enjoy the freedom that comes from the control of your inner world of mind and emotions. No matter what's going on out there, that's a challenge with what we see in the world conflict today. My war is with myself and dealing with what I think. Woo! And it ain't good. Do you find that happening? And it's like, there's that damn fast river, and there's my fishing line down there. I've been reeling all week getting it back because I know I can't do anything by feeding the problem. I can only make a contribution by feeding the solution. Don't matter whether it's a war or whether it's just dealing with my day-to-day life, it's the same way. Ernest Holmes said, "For it is not by any external power, nor through objective might, that our work is to be done, but through the Spirit and the law," much like Dr. Maxine said. "The Spirit guides us, the law executes. That which we can take is given." How much we can take? Can we take? As much as we believe. Just like going to the well with a cup, a pail, or a bucket. You get to take whatever you can. Well, he's got a bucket. Well, get rid of your pail. Make a bucket. Zeno, the Greek philosopher, said the most important part of learning is to unlearn our errors. And, of course, Reverend Doug, your altitude is determined by your attitude. You can soar with the eagles or scratch with the turkeys. It's your choice. The other thing I want to say here for each and every person, which is really important in my opinion for our emotional well-being and the well-being on our journey. No matter who you are or how much you know or how you think you've got it, you got to understand there's a value and importance in having a mentor, a counselor, a guide, a prayer practitioner, a therapist, or therapy. I get therapy in the mountains, or a confidant. But you need to have, and I'm going to negate all that, you need to have someone that you can share with that isn't going to say, oh, gee, you didn't deserve that. No, I don't do that if you want me. I'm going to tell you like it is. And generally, a lot of people don't like that. So that's why I don't have a lot of people asking me. Okay? But that's what you need. You need somebody that's going to be kind, compassionate, and respectful enough of you to tell you like it is and to guide you to doing solution for that. Okay? Very important thing. No matter who you are or what you do. Like I said, when I was in the hospital, I had my two practitioners who I highly respected come and do that work for me. I was upset when they told me that. I thought they had got together to plan it, but they didn't. Because they were right. Don't you like it when they're right about, people are right about something and you don't like it? Damn. That's the stuff you got to look at, folks. And that's why you need to have someone that you could go to. Not somebody who's going to give you airy-fairy stuff or get out a Jungian psychologist's book and analyze you, I should say. You need to have the straight goods in a caring manner so somebody can help bring you along from the place you are to a better place of thinking. 43 years, I still have a few people left. I still work with that idea. So I'm not telling you, oh, you should do it, but I don't do that anymore. None of that kind of stuff. So I'm going to close here with something called my most important relationship. It's by Abraham Hicks, and he said, my most important relationship is with my source. There is no relationship of greater importance to achieve than the relationship between you in your physical body right here and now and the soul source God from which you have come. If you tend to that relationship first and foremost, then you will and only then have the stable footing to proceed into your other relationships. Your relationships with your own body, your relationship with money, your relationship with parents, children, grandchildren, the people you work with, the government, your world, will all fall swiftly and easily into alignment once you tend to the fundamental primary relationship first. That is, as I know for myself, I know for each of you, God in me, God as me, God through me, by means of me, in my own unique and special way. So I declare that, I accept it, I open to it, I give thanks that it is so, and so it is. Whee! Thank you. Whee!
So good. I feel like I could go out there and just take on the world. I was looking at this. I can't believe that this song came to me like in 2016. It's like, where has the time gone? I'm thinking that date must be wrong. it's a song that, yeah, came to me, and yeah, I know. It's been a while. And it's called Light Up, Shine On, Be Bright, and if you want to sing along with that, you're more than welcome to. One. There are those who see the suffering and hate and choose to live with all the pain. And there are those who see the same and choose to smile and dance and sing despite the rain. It's within our hearts where we open up and we play the pain. burden, you can find eternal possibilities. It's within our hearts where we open up and we play a bigger part.
Thank you, Vivian, and the Unity Band. Let's give them another hand.
Woo-hoo. Thank you. Bravo.
Oh, yes. And for those of you who may not be aware, Tuesday, March 8th, is International Women's Day. And here's these beautiful women showing why.
Every day is
we need to celebrate.
Come on.
That's right. That's right.
Every day.
Well, thank you, Reverend Doug, for another wonderful talk. Getting connected with that, with Source, with the love and light within yourself, is the path to healing. Let's not forget that. And it's that connection with Source first that leads the way to more peace, more love, more joy in our lives. And now it's time for conscious giving. I want to thank you all for the giving that you give each week, even if it's just being here, that is a gift. It is what creates this community, just your presence. And any time that you spend volunteering, helping out, stacking chairs, unstacking chairs, bringing snacks, whatever it is, makes the difference. It makes the community. You are the Unity community. Don't forget that. And I am so grateful. And all of you out there watching on YouTube and Facebook, you make a difference every Sunday by showing up. And do we have a list of the names of all the people that are there? It'd be nice to get that to Vivian before her final song so she can acknowledge all of those people whose energy and attention helps build this community as well. You can place your donation in the baskets at the back by filling out a donation. And if you want a receipt for your donation so you can claim it on your taxes at the end of the year, please make sure that you fill out your whole name and contact info if you're not a member. If you are a member, you already have that info. So please fill that out. You can donate online at unityofcalgary.org or by going to our website, or you can actually even mail in a check to Unity of Calgary. We're going to be singing our offering song, and then our very own Katie Grinham is going to come up and do the blessing today because Cecil sprained his wrist. So he's got it in a wrap and everything. He's staying home and holding it up and praying, doing affirmative prayer on it as we speak. And perhaps he's online as well watching our Sunday experience today. So let's please all stand up and sing our offering song together, Give with an Open Heart.
I'm gonna give with an open heart. I'm grateful for this moment. I am grateful for my life. And I trust that a higher power will always be there to provide. That's why I give with an open heart. Oh, well, I place my faith in the Spirit, and I welcome each and every day. When I let go of all my troubles and worries, a new abundance always comes my way. That's why I give with an open heart.
And now we'll have Katie give a blessing.
Just get the blessing up front there so everybody can say it together. There we go. Good morning, everyone. Yes, and we'll send a big hug out to Cecil, shall we? Big hug, saying, we know that he will be, knowing Cecil, as you say, he is probably affirming up a storm, and that hand will be better in no time. So let's bring our focus and our energy and love together as we affirm divine love as me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And so it is.
All right. And now the blessing for the children. The very own children that are here today, Mia, Faith, and Lauren. So nice to have you here, bringing your beautiful energy. All the children of the world, and of course, our very own inner child. Very important to give that inner child lots of love. Let's please affirm out loud together. We love you, we bless you, And we appreciate you just the way you are. Now let's just take a quiet moment to bring to our awareness anything that we want to surrender into prayer. For we know that turning our concerns over to Spirit opens the way for abundant blessings to unfold. Just take a moment. We have our prayer box up front, and there are prayer requests at the back with their own table. You can write prayer requests on those papers and put them in the prayer box. You can, right now, just in your own mind, bring to mind anyone, anywhere in the world that you would like to bring a prayer to. More light, more peace, more love. Let's just take a special moment to hold in our awareness everything that's happening in the Ukraine. And send them love. On both sides. Let's not pick sides. Let's see them all opening their hearts. Finding not their differences, but their similarities. See peace like a rain shower washing over the Ukraine today. And know that just holding that intention is powerful and can and will make a difference. You can also put in your prayer requests at unityofcalgary.org or prayer@unityofcalgary.org. And if you need a prayer, an affirmative prayer for yourself or someone you know, you can call 1-800-NOW-PRAY 24/7. And these prayers will be held, the prayers that you send to Unity of Calgary will be held here with our prayer ministry for 30 days, and also at Silent Unity for 30 days. There's a place at Silent Unity that is high up, and it's called the Silent Unity Prayer Room, and they've been praying in that room 24/7 for 100 years. And that is where your prayers go for 30 days, held in that energy. Isn't that a beautiful thought? Wow. We also hold in love each month other Unity centers. And this month, we only have one. And guess what it is? Unity of Calgary. Woohoo! So we're receiving prayers from all across Canada today. Let them in. We are supported. And it says here, we have a normal statement. We see them having the love and support they need to continue cultivating the unity consciousness and bringing the message of unity across our country. That's us. Yes. We can receive it, we can send it, and receive it for ourselves. And as part of that, we have a prayer of protection. So let's please affirm this prayer out loud together. The light that is God surrounds us. I am the light. The love that is God enfolds me. I am the love. The power that is God protects me. I am the power. The presence that is God watches over me. I am the presence. Wherever I am, God is, and all is well. And so it is. Amen. And now we get a little bit more music from Vivian and the Unity Band. Let's please welcome them back.
All right. Woo! Ha ha! All right. get to stand. Let's stand and sing this one. Get some energy going. Here we go.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
All right.
Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine.
Did we get any names?
Yes, we did.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, we did. I always feel like Romper Room. Anybody watch Romper Room from back east? Magic Mirror, tell me today, did all my friends have fun at play? And we see, that's right, we see Adele and Flo, Chris, Verna, Susan, Sarah Beth, Lorraine, Claude, Cecil, Joanne. Oh, thank you for joining us.
Yes, thank you for joining us. Once again, thank you, Vivian Martin, and the Unity Band.
Yeah.
Woohoo! That was fun. Thank you, Reverend Doug Craig, for sharing your wisdom with us. And thank you all, both here, present, and all of you out there on watching on Facebook and YouTube. Now, let's please come around, stand in a great big circle, and we will sing our closing song, Let There Be Peace.
One, two, three.
thank you all for coming today. Have a wonderful Sunday. Stick around for some conversations that matter with people who care.